Welcome back to EMM Partners Leadership Insight Series. In the last episode, we spoke to a select group of private equity and venture capital experts on the business opportunities arising out of the pandemic and how they see the India story shaping. In continuation of our conversation, in this episode, we speak to them about the skills and competencies they are betting on in the world of tomorrow.
Some of the key qualities that we look for in a founding team is one, the ability to sell, the ability to sell to your prospective investors, to prospective hires, to your customers, to your vendors. And when I say sell, it's not being fake. It's being the ability to weave your ideas into a story which becomes appealing to the other party. The second important thing for us is the ability to adapt, to receive feedback, to assimilate that feedback, to analyze that feedback and course correct if needed. The third important thing for us is unflinching integrity, and integrity in all walks of life, not just your business dealings. And last but not the least, hunger or passion towards the idea. This is a lonely journey with a lot of ups and downs. And it's just that hunger or that passion that's gonna help a founder wade through all the downs that they will see over the life of this company and their involvement with the company.
COVID has shown how important it is for businesses to be agile. And this agility comes right from the top leadership, but also from the processes which the businesses have. Businesses which have been agile in terms of their ability to understand customers' needs and for them to be able to change their processes have been far more successful during COVID times. And I think this will be a very important due diligence item for investors. The second aspect where leadership could make a whole lot of difference in post-COVID world is your empathy. Your empathy, when I say, I mean empathy towards your employees, towards your ecosystem, your environment in which you operate, as well as the broader cause of the society. I think all of this will play a greater role for you to establish long-term businesses in the years to come.
We don't think that fundamentally character traits will change. You still need to be patient, you still need to be perseverant, you still need to be persistent. We would need individuals to be more digitally savvy, as sort of a lot of consumption behavior is sort of moving towards online purchasing. Businesses have an omni-channel approach. And from a business skill set perspective, I think all businesses, especially that have a front end and businesses which have a B2B2C angle, will need to start living in an omni-channel environment with the advent of some big industrial groups into some of the largest markets and them disrupting things digitally. We are going to see a lot more sort of activity, business being done online, and that is also going to reflect in the kind of skill set the market will require on a go-forward basis. You know, at a higher level, I think digitization of businesses will be a key driver of what skill sets businesses need.
I'm a big believer of two skills, one being learnability and the other one as customer centricity. I think learnability is self-explanatory, and I would just spend a few minutes or a few seconds on customer centricity. In technology, we call this organization as a product organization that is bridging the gap between the core tech organization and the business organization. And that product thinking is how an end consumer receives what an Uber is, what an Amazon is, what a Flipkart is, what an Ola is, through an app or through a web browser, through customer service, through payment checkout options. And I think that skill is extremely important in leaders of tomorrow. we all need to have our customers at the center of all our processes and our thinking. One of the big traits and one of the big skills in addition that I think that is needed is also to solve unstructured to structured, which is basically processing uncertain, half or incomplete or non-existing information and making decisions and making sense of that data.
The top four for me are one, compassion. The world is changing pretty fast, and there's not much of compassion in the world for humans and people around. So in that context, I think compassion would be my first behavior slash competency for humans to have in the world. The second one is listening, because that's an important essence of communication, to have good conversations. So the second one is listening. The third one is problem solving. We all know in the newer world, each one of us need to bring in efficiency, productivity, and opportunity to excel. So problem solving is an important area. Either it is in finance, human resources, supply chain, everywhere there are a lot of problems to solve. From structure point of view, from the process point of view, and from the efficiency and efficacy point of view. The last one of the four is behavioral science. With the hybrid world of online and offline, humans need to understand behaviors and understand what needs to be done.
In today's world, a leader has to have multifaceted, multidimensional capabilities. And there are probably around three or four different fronts, and especially in the post-pandemic world, I think that becomes a lot more acute in a few areas. The first, especially coming out of this situation, is high degree of both personal as well as professional empathy. Empathy is really required at different levels. Secondly, the ability to continuously evolve and change and have the self-learning to be able to do so. A lot of times where there is contentment that sets in, and I think that's one of the biggest enemies that that leaders would have. The third, again, is to be able to, to at least to a semi-permanent extent, is to be able to manage large distributed teams, because this whole phenomena of working from home or being in far-flung areas, not necessarily at the same time, that's definitely here to stay. So the future of work and how you are able to manage teams, how you're able to hire teams, how you're able to build teams, and how those teams are then enabled to thrive, that becomes important.
I want to speak about three aspects which we have now emphasized on in this new framework, which is also forward-looking for the world of tomorrow. The first is having a disruptive mindset. And two aspects of the disruptive mindset are an extreme focus on the customer, so customer centricity, and a huge adoption of technology. Second is strategic agility. We are now seeing rapid changes and lots of volatility. So without having the ability to think ahead and being resourceful, I think again business leaders will not be able to win. The third and final I want to talk about is resilience and emotional maturity. And this is very, very important to manage manage disruptions, manage volatility, build a strong team, which is agile.
I would bet on three skills. One, being digitally comfortable. The future consumer is going to spend a lot of time and increasingly more time digitally, and to be able to succeed in selling them products, services, or even dealing with them, you need to be able to understand the digital world, be comfortable in it, and understand how the consumer is spending his or her time. Second, the pandemic has taught us that life is uncertain. Things may go wrong and not go to plan. And therefore, to be able to deal with uncertainty, to adapt to a situation, and to be able to take decisions without full data or full knowledge of what's coming up next will be an important life skill. And finally, I would bet on resilience, because things will go wrong in spite of all the planning and all the scenario discussions. Things will go wrong. And if you have to succeed in life, you have to forget your mistakes, brush them aside, and move forward again by showing a great amount of resilience.